All right, here we are with Larry Koth. Give us a tour of the work here at La Frontera.
Love to. Let me show you the first kind of wrecking crew, what we're doing here. This is kind of what we're doing at most of the every room and classrooms that we have on both floors.
You're holding, yeah.
So, Kurt, we're taking out all of the ceiling tile, every room, and in the hallways, and we're stacking the ceiling tile out in the be able to get them, let them have access to this here with all the electrical heating air conditioning is, because you've got to get this up to code. In addition, we're taking the insulation down in another room. And then we're taking down all of the closets, any of the infrastructure that's in here to give them more room, because they'll take a typical classroom of this size and make it into three or four individual rooms for people, you know, homeless people, assisted living places, and things like that. So we're trying to take them down in such a way we can use the doors and the trim for future use. So we're stacking that and taking the nails out as well. And once we get all that done, we'll sweep the clean room.
They're going to reuse all these doors?
We're going to reuse all these doors.
2x4s and stuff?
2x4s and trim.
Wow.
We're taking the nails out of the room. I'm a walking disaster. I'm a demolition
man. Just more of the same in here?
Yeah, so more of the same, except for we've got a little more gentler crew in here, less testosterone, which is good. But they've got an interesting challenge, because these, instead of being drywall, these are all plywood. So this will be a little bit heavier.
What are you ladies doing?
Taking
ceiling tiles out?
Yeah, we can't, we're just trying.
Are you getting that insulation stuff in your...
A little bit.
Nice. Wow, so this is... all those rooms are just like this.
Yeah.
And so you guys are the first phase getting the ceiling tiles out?
Yep. So we just want to do them all down. Oh, you want to?
Awesome. Good job, ladies. Great, beastly, awesome women doing.
The grass and soil is just over years not being used. It's washed over the solid driveway here. And they're going to use this for handicapped parking for elderly that might come in. So we're going to clear all this back, and then we'll power wash it and get out of the way. And they're going to put a gate in over here so people can come right off the street, right into the handicapped parking, and then get the building.
Nice. Good job, ladies. Give me a big like flex. Hi, there's no air conditioning, and they are soaked to the bone, right, Patrick Bard? Soaked to the bone. They got these old plastic things on so that the insulation doesn't get all over their arms. So, right, Mark? You hanging in there? Hi, Caitlin.
Hello.
What you doing?
I am taking nails out of wood.
And what are you listening to?
Oh, what I missed!
Hello, ladies. They could have made these into like confessionals.
Woo!
Yes,
you
can. Yes,
I'm standing here with Mr. Jorge Diaz, who used to work for Bimbo Bakeries, and these bread trays,
he designed them. Because this is the low position, and when you have bread, you just turn it around, and they stack up, you know.
And it's got more space for bread, but if you have donuts,
you turn it around, and they slide.
And they have this.
That incredible design by Bimbo Bakery that is in use today was designed by this man right here, Jorge Diaz, our very own St. Anne, Mission Laredo.
Jorge. Ya cumplió más de 1,000 años y parece siempre un niño que le dio tanto.